just really, you know, I think like most teams right now, I think we're just, we feel really grateful that we get to compete. You know, I really appreciate the efforts of the conference and our administration to allow us to be in this position where we can have this. I was just telling my team just this past weekend, you know, what a long way we've gone in that, you know, 4 or 5 months ago, we didn't know if we were going to have this opportunity. So, you know, I think as we think about these next 2 weeks and what we're trying to do, you know, I think, again, it's just being grateful. It's having fun. It's enjoying it, you know, and just, you know, I don't think any of us are ever going to take this for granted, you know, ever again. The Big Ten meet is going to be a little bit different this year. Typically, the swimmers and divers would be combined in one site. But due to, you know, COVID and numbers and trying to be aware of social distancing, they've pulled them out. So, you know, our women, like Jess said, are in Minneapolis. The divers are in West Lafayette, and then the men will be in Columbus next week. And, you know, our expectations are to go there, and we're going to do the best job we can. We had a pretty successful kind of dual meet season. Both teams got two dual meets in. We had two home competitions at our new facility in January and February. That went pretty well. I believe the men went 3-0, the women went 3-1. So we feel good about where we are heading into this meet. I think like every year, our goals are to try and score more points and improve our standing in the conference. The women were fifth last year, the men were fourth. And then also put ourselves in position to try and qualify for the NCAA championship meet. So, and we've just received word that that meet looks like it's going to happen. There's going to be some differences to it. It's not going to be the same as in years past, but I do think we're going to have the opportunity to advance athletes and relays and teams to go on to the NCAA championship. So, you know, we're looking at 4.5 days of pretty intense competition. It's going to be a little bit different, but that's okay. And we're excited about the opportunity. On the women's side, we have a relatively younger team. And one person in particular, like Jess mentioned, that's just done a great job for us this year is Phoebe Bacon. Phoebe is a freshman. She comes from Bethesda, Maryland. She was a member of the U.S. national team. Has just come in and really just done a great job. She's a great teammate. She's a great leader. She's a great voice on our team. And we're expecting her to go there and really shine in the Big Ten. We feel fortunate to have her. Obviously, you know, last year, you know, Beata Nelson, the last 4 years, Beata Nelson, was really a huge part of our women's swimming and diving team. And for Phoebe to come in and kind of step into those shoes, she's not quite as fast short course yards as Beata is, but she's been able to come in and do a great job kind of filling in. And, you know, it's no one can replace Beata, right? Beata was just an awesome talent, a great person, a great teammate. But Phoebe certainly has helped us, you know, kind of deal with the loss. We have a couple other freshmen that we're expecting to shine. Emily Ecker from Maine is a distance swimmer that had some really nice dual meet swims. And we have a girl from the Milwaukee area, Kaylin Schuf. One of the better swimmers to come out of the state of Wisconsin last year's class, who's also had a really nice freshman year. So, you know, whenever you start naming off names you, as a coach, you always run the risk of forgetting someone. And so I'll stop there, but no, we're excited to see how they do.
Thank you, Coach. We have a question from Alec.
Hi, Coach. What has it been like? I mean, you touched on it a little bit, but what has it been like from a swimming standpoint, competing through a pandemic? Every sport has kind of crazy stories that they've had to deal with to get through this. What has it been like from a swimming standpoint?
Yeah, it's, you know, I think in some ways we have been deemed and we are a low risk sport by the NCAA and by the Big Ten. We still have to wear masks. We still try and social distance. We still have to be aware of our numbers in the lane or the locker room. You know, for instance, our dual meets this year, we, instead of having the athletes on the pool deck, kind of, you know, cheering, yelling, you know, they were up in the stands, which actually kind of worked out really well considering that we didn't have fans in the stands. So the fact that the athletes were all in the stands actually helped with a little bit of the environment. But it's, you know, it's been an adjustment for sure. But I think that, you know, fortunately our sport is not one, we're not a contact sport. The pool atmosphere is not conducive, is, you know, knock on wood, is deemed really not conducive to transmitting the virus. But there have been, we've had some disruptions just like every other team. You know, we've had some disruptions through this season. And I think, you know, the one thing that we've kind of just you know, in some ways it's been like, hey, it hasn't been a normal year. So, you know, you, as a coach, you throw your expectations out the window just a little bit and say, well, hey, you know what? Everyone's kind of in the same boat. We've all missed a little bit of time, or we've had to kind of stop here, or we've been quarantined here. And, you know, hey, we're just going to go there and do the best job we can. So, you know, there's been some specific things that we've had to deal with, but I think by and large, it's just, you know, you take it day by day, you take it week by week. And you know, again, we're just fortunate that we're here in this position.
We have a question from Brian Posick.
Hi, Yuri. Thanks for your time today. Hey, what's it been like, you know, swimming in your new facility? I mean, it looks so beautiful from outside. What's it like inside?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, you know, I think had we had to, you know, kind of deal with the pandemic in the natatorium, my mood would have been a lot different this year. and you know, that facility had a lot of history there. And so I certainly don't want to, you know, speak ill of it. But, you know, with only having 8 lanes and kind of being 55 years old, it would have been a challenge. And so with the new facility this year, we had more space. So we were actually able to have our whole team in together. Had we done this in the natatorium, we probably would have had to have had 3 or 4 even practice times, because that pool is so small. And so we've been able to kind of, you know, kind of keep everyone together. You know, I think in that pool, not to get too specific, but as a coach, I always felt like we were writing practices kind of to go right down the middle, where we could, you know, kind of take care of sprint a little bit, take care of distance a little bit. But when you have a facility like this, you're able to get more specific. We can have our sprint group, we can have a stroke group, we can have a distance group. Our divers, instead of having to go to Milwaukee once a week, you know, and kind of have a 3-hour round trip on the road to touch the 10-meter platform, they've been able to do that here. You know, they don't have to leave campus anymore. So for the divers, that was a really big thing. You know, we've been able to swim a little bit of long course, you know, with this being an Olympic year, you know, with the Olympics being postponed. And, you know, by all accounts, it looks like Tokyo is going to happen. You know, we do have a handful of athletes that are trying to impact, you know, their various national teams. And so, you know, kind of the underlying current behind the NCAA season is getting them ready for the international season as well. So having that facility where we can swim 50 meters, you know, every once in a while and kind of touch that race course has been really beneficial as well. So, yeah, it's been an awesome thing. It was a real bright spot. You know, we were swimming outside in the month of September as they finished up the facility, and then we were able to start swimming October 1. And just, you know, the smiles on their faces, the joy of just kind of walking in to that pool was, it was awesome. That was a real shot in the arm for the program.
Additional questions for Coach Sugiyama? Coach, what can we, you've talked about a number of the new faces and Phoebe and some of the other swimmers you've mentioned. Are there any of the divers that we should be looking out for as they go to their own championship?
Yeah, we do. We have a returning NCAA qualifier in Tasman Abramowitz. So Taz was a finalist last year at the Big Ten Championships. We're hoping that he'll do the same thing again this year. You know, and then from there, hopefully he'll qualify for zones, and then from zones qualify for NCAAs. And so he was slated to compete at NCAAs last year, didn't have that opportunity due to COVID. So hopefully he can put himself in a position this year to qualify for zones again. We have a freshman from Arizona, Daniel Muller, who's done a really good job, who's come in and made an impact. We have a sophomore from Wisconsin, Braden Rumpet. And then we have 2 women, one from a freshman from California, Allie Barnes, and another sophomore from Connecticut, Kit Greenberg. So the 5 of them, you know, I appreciate their efforts, and they're going to go there and do the best job they can. You know, diving in the conference, I would say the Big Ten, big diving in the Big Ten is probably the deepest, best conference in the country. So they face stiff competition. But, you know, we took some big steps forward as a program last year there, and I anticipate, you know, continuing with that trend.
We have a question from Kelly.
Hi, Yuri. I wanted to ask you a little bit about Lily and what you have seen from her this year and what you're kind of expecting from her at the Big Ten.
For sure. You know, Lily is one of the fastest returning 200 freestylers in the conference and really kind of the country. And I think for her, what I'm looking for is for her to just put together, a really solid meet. I think freshman year, she had a really good Big Ten meet. She was disqualified in one meet, one comp, one event, the 200 IM last year. Again, put together a great meet, was a key component of some relays. You know, we won the 800 free relay on that first night last year. She's going to play a big role in that again this year. And so, you know, I think from Lily's perspective, not only is she going to impact us individually, but, you know, Lily's going to play a big role in some of our relays and in the sport, you know, in NCAA swimming and diving, relays score double points. They're really important, not only important from a point perspective, but just from an emotional perspective, from a just a momentum perspective. And so, you know, I think for Lily, I think as someone who has now done this for 2 years, she's an All-American on a relay. She's a Big Ten champion on a relay. You know, I'm going to look to her to kind of really help us anchor those relays, you know, settle down maybe some of the younger women that maybe have a little bit of nerves about their first Big Tens and be a great example there. And, you know, she in her own way, she's going to do that. You know, I fully expect that. But, you know, with Lily, her individuals are going to be really good, but we're going to need her to be really good in our relays as well.